Section 2.3, savings accounts. Sample 5. How much simple interest does $2,000 earn in 7 months at an interest rate of 2%? So this is a simple interest equation. So this is I equals PRT, where we need to know the I, the P, the R, and the T. So how much does $2,000 earn? So that's my principal, my $2,000. I have 7 months. Time in years, so that would have been 7 over 12 months would have been my time. And I have an interest rate of 2%. I need to change this into a decimal. Looking at this, there is no decimal point. That means the decimal point is currently right here at the back, hidden. You move it 2 spaces to the left to get your new decimal point. So this is 0 point, there's an empty space there, and then the 2. So that's my decimal. I have no I, and that looks like that is what it's asking me. How much simple interest do I earn? That is what my I is. So let's calculate I. I equals, I need my P. My P is 2,000. My R is a 0.02. And my T is a fraction of 7 over 12. Multiplying all of this together on my calculator, I get I to be 2, 3.333333. It repeats. It tells you to round to the nearest cent. Cents have 2 place values. So that meant this is where I cut it off for cents. This 3 is going to be the last number placed. This 3 tells us what we're doing. So since this is smaller than 5, he's going to boss this number around and say stay exactly where you are. So my rounded interest is 23.33, and interest is how much money you've earned. So this is $23.33. So my final answer is $23.33 worth of interest earned in 7 months. Now let's go ahead and check your understanding. How much simple interest would? Well, it sounds like I'm using the simple interest equation again, which means I need an I, a P, an R, and a T. So how much is earned? Which means I'm looking for my I. If $800, no, how much simple interest would $800 earn, yep, $800 earn in 300 days? Time needs to be in years. So 300 days would have been 300 out of the 360 days available in a year, because it's a non-leap year. Non-leap years have 365. It says non-leap year because leap year matters. You get an extra day in here if it's a leap year. It's a non-leap year, so it's 365. So you're gonna only use 300 out of the 365 days, and your interest rate is 1.71%. Well, I need my percent to be rewritten as a decimal. So remember, decimal needs to be moved over 2 to the left, so my decimal goes there. So this is 0 point, there's a placeholder where another 0 is supposed to go, 171. So I'm supposed to figure out my I. So my P is an 800. My R is a 0.0171, and my T is a fraction of 300 over 365. So typing all of that into the calculator, multiplying, I get I to be 11.2438. It's said to round to the nearest cent. Cents have 2 decimal values, so that means I'm cutting it off right here. To round appropriately, this is the last number, and this number tells you whether or not you're going up or staying. Because he's smaller than 5, he's bossing him around, say, stay exactly where you are. So my interest earned is 11.24. So $11.24 worth of interest was earned after 300 days. Example 6. How much principal must be deposited to earn $1,000 in simple interest? So this one's different. We are still using the simple interest equation. So I still need I, P, R, and T. But this is asking how much principal. I don't know the principal. How much do I put in if I wanted to earn $1,000 in interest after 2 years using a 1.3% interest rate? I'm solving for P this time. But still, your R needs to be a decimal, which means I need to move this decimal point 2 to the left. So here's me moving it 2 to the left. So he's a decimal of 0.013. So I know I want $1,000. I don't know P. I do know my R, and I do know my T. So I need to solve for P. So first I'm gonna multiply these two numbers together. So I end up getting P times 0.026. And now I need to get P by itself. Since P stuck to the number by multiplication, you unstick it by dividing. So I'm gonna divide both sides by the 0.026 number. These one each other out, and 1,000 divided by 0.026 gives me 38461.5 as my P. And this is how much principal, which means this is a dollar amount. So here's my dollar amount. 1, 2, 3, your comma would have gone there. So how much do you need to put in? $38,461.50 of principal is needed, $1,000 in 2 years at 1.3%. Let's go ahead and check your understanding. How much principal? So it sounds like I'm still using the simple interest equation. So I still have these variables to find, but it's asking how much principal. I don't know my principal. It says I have 2 years, so here's 2 years of simple interest and 1.75% rate to earn $300 of interest. So I want $300 earned. My rate needs to be converted into a decimal. So that means I need to take the decimal point and I need to move it 2 to the left. So I have 0.0175. So I have 300 for I. I don't know P. R is 0.0175, and T is a 2. So I need to solve for P, get P by itself. So first things, I need to multiply these two together. So I have 300 equaling P times, these two multiplied together is 0.035. I need to unstick these, and these are stuck together by multiplication. So we're going to unstick these by dividing. So divide both sides by 0.035. These two want each other out. 300 divided by 0.035 is 8571.43. Now that's principal, which meant this is a dollar amount. So here's my cents. 1, 2, 3 places, and then there is your comma. So you need $8,571.43 worth of principal to earn the $300 in interest in the 2 years at the rate of 1.75. Example number 7. Derek has a bank account that pays 2.1% simple interest. Sounds like I'm still using my simple interest equation. So here is my simple interest equation. The balance is $910. So this is how much I have right now. When will the account grow to be $1,000? So I need my I, P, R, and T. So I currently have $910. That is my principal. I have an interest rate of 2.1%, which I need to convert into a decimal. To convert it into a decimal, you move the decimal value 2 over to the left. So this is 0.021. Do I know time? It says when will, so I don't know time, which means I should know interest. Well, I want to get to 1,000. I'm currently at 910. Interest is how much did I needed to add to the 910 to get to the 1,000. So if I wanted the 1,000, had the 910, if I subtracted them, I found out that I need to earn $90 more to get there. So the question's asking, when will I earn $90 using this interest rate? So my interest, I needed to earn $90. I know my principal, I currently have 910. I know my rate, it's 0.021. I'm solving for T, I don't know how long it will take. So first I need to multiply these two together. So I have 90 equals 19.11 T. I need to get the T by itself. The T is currently stuck by multiplication. So you undo multiplication by dividing. So I'm gonna divide both sides by 19.11. These numbers want each other out. So I have 4.70958 equaling T. So this is my time. Time is in years. So I have 4.7 years. By 4.7 years, I need to know how many months. So if I have to multiply my years by, there are 12 months in every single year. So 4.7 years, 12 months, every single one of those years, I get about 57 months. So 57 months to earn the $90 needed. Let's go ahead and check your understanding. So how long will it take $10,000 to double at 11% simple interest? So I equals PRT is my equation. So these are the variables that I need to solve for. How long will it take to double? Well, if this is what I currently have and I want it to double, that means that's exactly how much I also want to earn. I know my rate is 11%. How long will it take is your time. So I need to rewrite this percent as a decimal. Because there isn't a decimal point here yet, that's because it was hidden, it's right here at the end. Move it over to, the decimal point is 0.11. So my interest, I want to earn $1,000. My principal, I already have $10,000. My rate is 0.11, and I don't know my time because I want to know how much time will it take. So first, I need to multiply these two together. So multiplying that together, I get 1100 T. Now I need to get T by itself. It's stuck by multiplication, so I need to unstick it by dividing. So I need to divide each side. 10,000 divided by 1100 is 9.09091. These two numbers blend each other out, and that gives me T. T is in years. So I have T equaling 9.09 years. And how long did it take? It didn't ask me to put it into months or anything. So how long will it take? It'll take about 9 years to double my $10,000 at the rate of 11%. Example number 8. Carrie invests $5,000 in a simple interest account for 5 years. So here is my simple interest equation. So she invests $5,000. So here's my principal of $5,000. The account is 5 years opened. What interest rate? Well, I guess I don't know my rate. Must the account pay so that there is $6,000 at the end of 5 years? Well, I already have five. I want $6,000 in the end, which means I need it to grow by $1,000 more. So let's go ahead and solve for I. So I need $1,000. I have $5,000. I don't know my rate, but I do know my time. So first I need to multiply these two together so I know what my number is. So 1,000 equals 5,000 times 5 is going to be 25,000, so it's 25,000 R. I need to unstick. The way to unstick multiplication is to divide, so I'm going to divide both sides by the 25,000. 1,000 divided by 25,000 is a 0.04. These one each other out and we're just given the R. So this is my decimal rate. But I need a percent rate. So if my rate is 0.04 and I want to turn this into a percent, we undo it. So that meant that you were going to move then to the right so he could then turn into a percent. So my rate is 4%. So I need a rate of 4% to earn $1,000 in 5 years. Now let's go ahead and check your understanding. Marcus deposited $500 into a 2.5 year simple interest account. So here is my simple interest equation. Let's read that again. He deposited 500. So my principal is 500. The time is 2.5 years. And that's all it tells me. He wants to earn $50 of interest. So I need to earn $50. What simple interest rate? What is your rate? All right, so I want $50 of interest using $500 of principal. I do not know my R, and my T is 2.5. So first thing I need to do is I need to multiply 500 times 2.5. That gives me 1,250 R. The R is connected by multiplication. I want to undo that, so I'm going to divide both sides by 1250. 50 divided by 12, 50 is 0.04. These one each other out and just give me the R. So my rate is 0.04, but I need my simple interest rate, which is supposed to be a percent. So you're supposed to take this decimal, move it 2 to the right, and it will turn into a percent for us. So I need 4% interest to earn $50 in 2.5 years.